Yeah, man. This is where you and your neighbor must go full speed ahead, right to Hermitage Dam, so you can see the reality of what is truly going on in Jamaica. Sloan is saying that when you look down here, this is about 30 feet of water that is not there. When you look back this way, where the camera is taking you, that is where the water should be coming from.
Right.
Now, if you notice, one of the points is there is no water coming from there, but there's no effort. There's no effort so far to even dig a ditch so that whatever water is left up there, the water would start to come down. There is no effort whatsoever. This is what we have. Blind leadership. Bankrupt politicians. Blind leadership. And let's not forget, dumb Jamaican people that don't even, you're not even concerned with the reality of your own country. Not even concerned. You're concerned with a dollar. Well, when you have your dollars in your pocket and you can't drink water, come talk to me. When your country, which is bankrupt already, finally shuts down, come talk to me. When you have ministers rejoicing because they get to borrow another $200-300 million, is that something to rejoice about? The opposition before, when they were government, they used to rejoice whenever they have an investment, which means they sold off another piece of property to foreigners who don't give a damn about this country and who takes the money and ship it to their country. This is the reality of what we have. Well, in my opinion, and I know I talk quite passionately, you may not like what I have to say, but I don't give a damn. I'm speaking that which I believe God is inspiring me to say. And I live my life based on the Spirit of the Lord. I am saying that, not mine, that your time is up. Why is it not mine? Anyone who do good and is righteous and believe in God, there is no fear, nor shall they grieve. You will make it through, but you have to do something. Faith without works is dead. And what the church is preaching, the church isn't preaching about the fact that there's no water left in the dam. They're preaching doom, and the reality of it, they're not even bringing their congregation out to see it because they're false prophets. They're fake. So you can hallelujah all you want. The fact is that if you don't have the faith and the works to clean up not only the country itself, work to bring roots from the rest of the rivers that we have in Jamaica into these areas. Sloan, when we were here when? Last year? 2 years ago?
Not even so long ago, less than 6 months ago.
No, we were longer than that, man.
I came here in
November. With me.
With you?
We came here over a year ago.
Yeah.
And we were talking about the deterioration then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And again, let me make it clear. It's not a JLP thing, you know. Because PMP had the country for 18 years. And this is the reality.
Still there.
So don't get me wrong. Okay, good. Not that I give a damn what you think. I'm just simply saying, or I'm plainly stating, that as young people, and more than likely this is on Facebook and YouTube, as young people, you need to become concerned over your country. Financially, I repeat and I end, Jamaica, April 2010, as we get into a new budget, your country is bankrupt. You are through financially. I can make it clear. Good. Where food is concerned, importation is the order of the day. Your farmlands in St. Elizabeth, your farmland all over Jamaica now are drying up because of what? Lack of water. Your water system is now destroyed. And what's worse than all of this is there's no move on government, no move on opposition, no move in the private sector, and no move in the dead church to change the reality of Jamaica. So we will have no water and fires all over Jamaica, April 2010. Let me end by saying it. It is just the beginning.
One furthest away from the source. Mm-hmm. So there should be a deeper ditch here, deeper than even down here where the water is now settling. And that
the dirty water.
The dirty water. And that's where the water should be streaming from. And then they should just be cutting that section off, should be higher. So when it goes down there instead of going down here.
Mm-hmm. For a country like Jamaica with streams and rivers, we probably have one of the worst dams
Yep.
In the Western world.
Yep.
Dirt. Not even concrete, no. Dirt.
Dirt is your wall.
Dirt is the wall. Dirt is the ground. And this is what we drink. All right, man. So remember, we said it when we came in. We said, why no work has been done to the place?
Yeah, none.
What the English set up them left enough?
Yeah.
And with all of our building.
No swimming allowed. No swimming allowed. Come, who can swim in this?
Right, on this stone, it says, this stone was laid on the completion of this dam by His Excellency the Governor, Sir Reginald Edward Stubbs, KCMG, this 4th day of May 1927, Mayor Honorable Altamont DaCosta, MBE, Town Clerk W.J. Walker, J.P., designed by the Engineering Department, KSAC, City Engineers, H. Gold, R. Nielsen, constructed by Messer Sir W.G. Armstrong with work and company limited. So this dam was constructed in 1927. And what I'd like for you to do, since I've done some of the homework, go and do your homework to see how much work has been done in this dam that the Europeans at England built for Jamaica in 1927 for themselves. And see how much work, how much money we've actually put into the dam since 1927.
Infrastructure that we need to have.
Sorry.
The stuff that we need to have done. Stuff that we need to have done is, for example,
this is the
clearing out all the soil right here, leveling this section, raising that section over there, or even flattening it out, and then digging it deeper on this side going towards the stream entrance. All that can be done now when there's no rain, and since it's already that low. And then the last part of it would be to filter all that water coming in. All that money that we spend doing all sorts of other crap, we could spend it building pumps that would pump the water up out of the natural spring that is there and pump it in this direction.
The hundreds of millions. I mean, I like a nice road, you know. When you look at the hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars that is spent on road work, I would halt the road work and fix the dam in which we get water from to drink.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the things that we would do. But maybe there's not enough money involved in fixing the dam as there are in road work.
Mm-hmm.
Take people for idiots. That's not a problem. But then again, Jamaicans, we are the complete idiots. We caused it on ourselves.